Hello and welcome. My name's Debbie Pendergrast and I will be your host for this session. I'm Business Development Manager here at Keencut, and today I'm joined in the studio by my producer, Curtis.
Good afternoon, everyone. So I'll be in charge of audio and visuals for today's session. So if there are any problems at all, do give us a shout in the chat box. And if you have any questions about today's session, then give us a shout as well. If you need to be logged into YouTube to allow this function to be accessible to you. If you have any questions about the SteelTrak itself or any questions just regarding Keencut, then again, just put it in the chat box and I can let Debbie know and we'll go from there. I hope you enjoy the session.
Perfect, thank you, Curtis. So I'm going to take you through today's session on how to correctly calibrate and use the Keencut V-grooving tool. Now, the V-grooving tool is a very handy optional extra that goes along with the SteelTrak. And the SteelTrak is the rigid and semi-rigid material, but it's probably best known for its ability to be able to cut and finish in one very easy pass both steel and aluminium composite panelling. You might know that as die bond or alu panel. Now, how the V-groover works is that it actually takes out a piece of the material to be able to fold it down, which is really handy when you are producing things like sign trays. So we do here at Keencut, we do a range of V-grooving tools. We do five different sizes. We do a 2, 3, 4, 5 and a 6. And you have to be really mindful when you are ordering a V-groover that it corresponds with the correct thickness of board you're wanting to V-groove. So a 2 V-groove goes with a 2mm board, a 3 V-groove goes with a 3mm board, a 4, 4mm and so on and so forth. But you really have to be careful because you cannot calibrate a number 2 V-grooving tool to go through or to try and V-groove a 5mm board, for example, or a 3 tool to V-groove a 4mm board. It's just not happening. You can't do it. So depending on the thickness of board that you have will depend on the size of the tool that you use. Now, today I'm going to be using a number 3 to V-groove a 3mm board because that's the most common size of aluminium composite panelling. When you order your V-groover, when you receive it, you will receive it in a box like this. So upon opening the box, it has the sizing on it, and upon opening the box, you will find an instruction leaflet that tells you how to calibrate the tool, the V-grooving tool itself, the knob with which to house it securely on the steel track, and a 4mm to calibrate the tool. Now, the tool itself is actually housed onto the steel track, and it goes in the place of the C2 twin wheel composite head, which is this one here. So I have to remove this because the V-groover goes here. In order to remove this head, this is the default cutting head, so in order to remove this head, I'm going to turn this anti-clockwise until I remove it. So whilst I do that, I'm actually going to pass you back to Curtis.
Hi guys again. So I just wanted to quickly mention about our social media channels. So our Instagram, Twitter, Facebook and LinkedIn posts will be all posting to keep you up to date with all things new and all the dates of our live events. We'll be posting whenever we add new content, and our YouTube channel has loads of content too, including instructional videos, material tests, recorded live streams, custom reviews and workshops. So whenever you do visit our YouTube channel, just make sure you hit the subscribe button, and that will allow you just to keep up to date with any new content we do post.
Thank you, Curtis. So I now have my V-grooving tool. I have my V-grooving tool, I have my installation knob, and I have my Allen key. So at the back of the V-groover, on the plate at the back, there is a polarizing key here. This will install and go here. The blade itself, there's a number 3 on here, so all of them have their number. The blade itself of the V-groove has to go in the direction of the spine. So as long as it's facing towards the spine, you can house it with the knob in there, screwing it firmly in place. And once it's in place, it's not going to be moving. So it's quite secure. Now I need to actually calibrate the tool itself. So I'm taking a aluminium composite panel, in this case it's alu panel, and I need it to go onto the squaring arm and sit flat on the squaring arm. before clamping it firmly into place. Bringing down the V-grooving tool, I need to calibrate this. So in order to calibrate it, there is a screw here, and I need to unscrew that. Just loosen it up. Upon loosening that, the tool will move backwards and forwards. Now to calibrate it, you have to bring the blade down to the top of the board, so it's resting on the top of the board, and with your thumb on the back of the tool, press firmly against the board so that the wheel is touching and making contact with the face of the die bond. So as you push firmly towards, keeping that pressure constant, you can then tighten up the screw. Just have that probably in there. So constant pressure forward, tighten up the screw, so then that's not moving. Now for me, that's now calibrated. And all that's left for me to do is actually be able to test it to see if it's working. But before I do that, there are a few things you need to remember about V-grooving. First and foremost, the V-grooving tool is actually offset a little bit to the left of the machine of the sightline strip. So there's a sightline strip here. This is where the blade passes, and this is the line of cut. The V-grooving itself is actually offset slightly to the left of that, so be mindful of that. The second thing is, it's as easy to V-groove a 2.50 meter board as it is to V-groove a panel this size. The biggest difference is body stance. So when you're V-grooving something that's actually taller than yourself, you're transitioning from a pull motion through the shoulder to a push function. And on this transition, sometimes it's possible to unconsciously take a little bit of a motion backwards and lose the consistency and the contact against the board as you transition down to a push motion. That means that potentially at that point, the V-groover loses contact and becomes less deep. So as long as you're mindful to keep your body stance in perfect position and with contact to the board as you transition down, you shouldn't have an issue with that. The last thing is the fact that it's a little bit more challenging to V-groove a board than it is to actually cut it, because you, in cutting it, you are actually parting the material. But on V-grooving it, you're taking out a piece of the board itself, so there's a little bit of resistance there. So with that in mind, I need to give it a bit of a push downwards and continue my V-groove. Now here I have the material, the piece that's actually come out of the board, and I need to remove it. Please be careful at this point, because the edges could be very sharp. So as long as you're mindful and you just pull it out, then you can unclamp the board, bring the cutting head back to the middle of the machine, and there we have a perfect V-groove. Can you see that, Curtis?
Yeah, it's very clear. Can we go to camera two and we have a look there as well?
Yes, of course. Let's go to here.
And I'll just come and focus that for you.
Thank you.
Wonderful.
So you can see the consistency of that groove in the whole of the board along the whole length. So what that enables me to do is actually fold the board in on itself, which is, as I mentioned, really handy for when you are doing things like sign trays, which is something that I'm going to take you through, a process I will take you through in 2 weeks' time on the 16th of March. So do we have any questions, Curtis?
We don't currently at the moment.
Okay, perfect. So if you would like more information on any of our Keencut products, then you can visit our website at www.keencut.com. We also have social media accounts, so you can find out all the information and the news on our Twitter, LinkedIn, Facebook and Instagram accounts. So there you keep up to date with the shows that we do going forward. As I've mentioned, in 2 weeks' time, I'll be doing a how to make a sign tray show. And we're also housing all of our digital material on our YouTube channel. So this will be housed up on our YouTube channel for future reference. If you have any suggestions or thoughts, or there are any topics in particular you would like us to cover in one of these short, sharp sessions, then please do get in touch with us and let us know. I hope that you have enjoyed the session, and I've enjoyed your company. Thank you very much for watching. Curtis, would you like to sign off?
Yeah, so one last thing from me. If you do have anything to say about these sessions, do remember we're doing this for you. So any feedback you give us at all will be greatly appreciated. And apart from that, we hope all our best to you guys.
Thank you. So all that's left for me to say is many thanks for your company. I hope you have a very happy day wherever you are situated in the world.